Greetings and salutations, everyone. I'm back with another retro review here for an 80s film, The Legend of Billie Jean from 1985, starring Helen Slater and Christian Slater as siblings, though they are not siblings in real life, despite the last name. no relation at all, but I'd actually rewatched this one about 7 years or so ago, and so it's pretty fresh in my head, which is kind of strange for being 4 years or 7 years, but also when I was growing up, this was very popular on cable one summer, so back in the days before having unlimited streaming of every TV show, movie, game, song, book, everything that you could possibly want, back then you just had to kind of watch what you had access to, and this was one of those that if it was on cable, nothing else to do, you're going to end up watching it. So I probably watched it 10 times one summer way back. So, you know, watched it again 7 years ago and decided nobody really talks about this one. So let's do a quick little review of this. So the official synopsis states, a Texas teenager cuts her hair short and becomes an outlaw martyr with her brother and friends. Well, that's very basic. And I would not be interested in watching a movie with a description that was that short, but here's a little bit of a review to try to give you a little bit more information to see if it's something that you might want to check out. So yes, she cuts her hair, but that comes kind of later in the story, and I'll try to give a decent review that doesn't spoil anything, yet doesn't sound too bland. So yes, she's a Texas teenager, this Billie Jean, who's played by Helen Slater, and I'm guessing she's probably maybe about 19 or so, because she's got a younger brother named Binks, who's played by Christian Slater. And the reason why I think that she's, you know, probably closer to 19, he's probably around 15, is just the way that they kind of talk, the way that she seems to always want to take care of him and watch out for him, and how she likes to, you know, tell him stories about when she was younger and living in Vermont and how different the climate was, because it's just this long, hot, sweltering East Texas summer that they've been dealing with trying to cool off. Now, one of the things that comes up here, what it kind of centers around, is that her brother Binks, his prized possession is a Honda Elite scooter. And one day, one of the local boys, who always tries to give Billie Jean a hard time and her brother a hard time, steals that scooter. And he ends up, riding off with it. And by the time they're able to get that scooter back, after going to the police and talking about it and being told to wait a few days and see if the guy returns it, the scooter is trashed, and so is Binks. He's pretty, you know, beaten up pretty badly as well. So Billie Jean gets a repair estimate and decides to confront the kid and his father, Mr. Pruitt, to say, you know, this is what your son did. He owes us this money. And originally it seems like the father is going to pay up, but he has some other thoughts in mind about Billie Jean, and things go south pretty quick. Next thing you know, there's a bit of a scuffle. Binks accidentally shoots Mr. Pruitt, and now they're all on the run. So so now they're on a run, with some of their friends as well, who are kind of, you know, with them on this little attempt to get that money back. But along the way, there's news reports, not just about what happened, but about some stuff that didn't happen, you know, about them actually being on a crime spree, and everything's getting blown out of proportion. But while they're on the run, Billie Jean, who's always been seen as just this pretty little girl in town and that nobody will ever take her seriously, she gets inspired by, they're kind of holed up in another home where somebody's helping them out, and she sees she's watching a movie about Joan of Arc. I'm not sure which older movie it was, but it inspires her to kind of, you know, get more attention in a different way. So she decides to chop off all of her hair, change her image, and record a video, to basically have this delivered to the police to say, this is what's really going on and I want to be taken seriously. But once this gets out, she starts to develop a fan base, you know, thousands of people being on her side now that they understand a little bit more about what really happened, and they're not believing some of the negative press that's out there. They all want her to be paid back, because as she says in the video, fair is fair. So they're all falling in love with her. And there's even a point where teenagers, especially teenage girls, are starting to really idolize her. They're cutting their hair like hers, helping her out, even turning themselves in as being Billie Jean to try to throw off the police, giving her rides around town, keeping her off the police's radar. So as the story progresses along the lines, you know, the main goal here is just getting what she and her brother are owed, you know, that fair is fair, they should be paid back for the scooter, and, you know, they didn't really do anything wrong besides there was just that mistake, that accident that happened with the gun. So Yeah, that's a much longer description about the film, and I did, of course, leave out a lot of stuff because I don't want there to be any spoilers here. So, you know, after what was interesting was that, you know, I remember this being popular the summer that it kind of hit cable, and then about a decade later, it was seemingly forgotten by many. So does it hold up after 35 years or so? Yes, absolutely. Surprisingly, it really does hold up well. The filmmakers do a really great job of getting you up to speed on who these kids are, what their lives are like living in this trailer park, what their friendships are like, and you get pulled along very quickly into that journey. They throw in the fact that we've also got some really excellent pacing and never drags along the way. It's got a great 80s soundtrack, both in the score and in some of the 80s tunes that they've thrown in, such as some Pat Benatar and everything. And this idea of this small local situation that could, you know, become big even in the days before social media. You know, this is a local thing, but it's not just people going online and liking and sharing a post. I mean, these are people who are really behind her and really trying to help her out. It was interesting and very entertaining to kind of see how all of that would unfold in that situation. But like I said, I don't want to give away too much more about how the story turns out, but it's definitely one that has some nice twists and turns along the way. They even end up faking a kidnapping with somebody who was helping them out, so that way they could have some more leverage. But yes, I definitely recommend this one. Definitely give it a shot. I give it about a B+, because it does hold up really well. You know, it has some dated stuff, but if you're interested in some of these older 80s films, you'll like some of that dated stuff. Anyways, if you do decide to check it out, as of right now, I believe it's available for rental on YouTube as well as Amazon, but it's not part of like a bigger streaming service, so you will probably have to pay out of pocket for it. Anyways, B+, check it out. I think you'll enjoy it. And if you enjoyed this review, be sure to do the whole like and share and subscribe thing. And I'll see you in the next one.